IVF success depends on having a healthy, viable embryo and a normal receptive uterine lining. 10 years ago, the ERA test, or Endometrial Receptivity Array, was developed. Today, there are a number of tests to assess the uterine lining. These tests are expensive and invasive. Should you have any of these tests done? Stay tuned. The ERA test was used for many years, but is no longer recommended. Watch this video for more information about the recent studies which have shown that the ERA is not a useful test for people doing IVF. At IVF 1, we currently recommend looking for chronic endometritis, which is inflammation of the uterine lining. The gold standard for diagnosing endometritis is to look for a type of inflammatory cells called plasma cells. Although testing for endometritis is invasive, it requires a biopsy, it is very inexpensive, and there is good data that shows that people with high numbers of plasma cells have lower pregnancy rates in IVF, and importantly, treatment to reduce the number of plasma cells improves pregnancy rates. You can learn more about that here. Inflammation is commonly due to the presence of bacteria in the uterine cavity. Recently, there have been two tests that have become available which focus on the type of bacteria in the uterine cavity. The first test is called ALIS. This stands for Analysis of Infectious Chronic Endometritis. This name is deceiving. ALIS does not actually look for chronic endometritis. Diagnosing endometritis is made by finding high numbers of inflammatory plasma cells. The ALIS test looks for bacteria which may be associated with chronic endometritis. This is a very important distinction. The presence of bacteria, even abnormal bacteria, does not necessarily result in inflammation. In fact, in their own study, the company that offers this test found that there was little correlation between the results of their test and the presence of chronic endometritis diagnosed by plasma cells. The ALIS report does not even include an assessment for plasma cells. So far, there have not been any studies performed that show that having an abnormal ALIS result alone is associated with a lower IVF pregnancy rate. There are also no studies which have shown that treatment of an abnormal ALIS test in the absence of inflammation will improve pregnancy rates in IVF. A second test from the same company is called EMMA. EMMA stands for Endometrial Microbiome Metagenomic Analysis. A microbiome is the sum total of all of the bacteria in a certain part of the body. There has been much interest in microbiomes in recent years. It seems that some types of bacteria are important for maintaining our health. Your bowels have a microbiome, so does the vagina, and so does the uterus. This brings up some interesting questions like, do some people have an unhealthy uterine microbiome? If that is true, can an unhealthy microbiome reduce the chance for pregnancy? Can you change an unhealthy microbiome to a healthy one? And if you do, will that also improve the chance for pregnancy? The EMMA test is based on one very small study. There are a number of problems with this study. First, they looked at only 35 people who had an embryo transfer. But in three of those, they were unable to get any data about the microbiome, and all three of those people became pregnant. With such a small study, this alone could have completely altered the conclusions. 166 different types of bacteria were identified, but only levels of one bacteria, lactobacilli, were seemingly important. Pregnancy rates in this study were higher when 90% or more of the bacteria found were lactobacilli, compared to when it was less than 90%. However, the timing of the biopsy could change the results. Nearly 20% of the patients saw the percentages change from low to high within a few days. This study from a different group of researchers also looked at lactobacilli levels, but did not find any difference in the pregnancy rates. Even if we believe there is a difference, there haven't been any studies showing that any type of therapy can change these outcomes. Finally, I want to talk about a third test called the ReceptivaDx. This test looks at a marker called BCL6. The makers of this test claim that high levels of BCL6 are a marker for endometriosis and that the presence of endometriosis will prevent embryos from implanting. Studies do not seem to support this, however. This study compared pregnancy rates in people with or without endometriosis and found no difference. In addition, this study found no difference in the pregnancy rates in people with a normal or abnormal Receptiva test. Our Infertility TV bottom line is this. It's great that there is research going on which is trying to identify uterine causes for IVF failure. At the current time, however, that's all this is, research. None of these tests have been demonstrated to be a useful test that will help increase your chances for IVF success. In addition, they are expensive and invasive. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, ivf1.com, where you can become a patient.